So the idea about live tracking and group tracking is that you can see other riders, other runners, and also that your family, your friends can see you while running, cycling. And you have a couple of devices that support the live tracking function. The more expensive Forerunners and Garmin Edges. So you have like the Yahoo element that supports live tracking, and it's different than the Garmin because Wahoo at this moment has the live tracking, and you can see the route that the biker or the runner will go running if it is uploaded. The Garmin only shows you the written track or the run track, so that's different. You can also live track in a couple of apps on your phone. They're not free because you need the Strava Live app. That's the premium, that's paid version. And also the Runtastic app, you can do some live tracking. And of course, just normal Google has the live tracking function, but it's not on the device like a watch or Garmin Edge, which is supposed to be here. So what do I prefer? Battery life of phones is a great issue, especially if you go like running for half a marathon, or you go like riding for a couple of hours, then battery life on the phone is a big issue. So better, I think, is to use a separate device which doesn't drain your phone as quickly as all the live tracking on the phone. You can of course take battery pack, but yeah, that's a lot of weight and also a lot of hassle to do. So and also of course the watches and the Edges and the Wahoo and other bike computers, which do not support, by the way, only the Garmin Edge and the Wahoo, the Element, at this moment support the live tracking. So yeah, they are of course great for live tracking, but also great for seeing the distance, the speed, average heart rate, etc., like on the 935.